You know, tears of joy, tears of happiness, tears of sorrow, they're all tears, right? I want to tell you, whenever I knew Sibby was in the house, it made me really want to sing better. Because such a joyful guy, he would always come up after the show, "Man, you killed it, man. You nailed it. You always nail it." He always had such a great word. Not everybody does that, but Sibby always did it. And I'm going to tell you, this is a special trip, this trip right here. This is a life-changing trip. And I just want you to know that after we leave, just keep praying for the family. Keep praying for Sibby's family, because you know, the prayers really do work. In fact, Suzanne said, it's helping. And, you know, we love you. We love your family. We're going to keep you in our prayers forever. Ever. Okay? And, you know, I'll tell you, be straight up and honest with you, John and Phil and I were saying a little prayer backstage before we go on, because we just want to know that everything that we've been through here together, these are the ties that bind right here. This is love, okay? And God is great. And if you believe in God, don't stop believing, okay? Don't stop believing. She took the midnight train going anywhere. fun so far. Yeah, baby. Well, it's not going to end for a while yet. If you saw our show in the black and white the other night, then you got to see the fresh meat on the tour. Here he comes, man, from Nashville, Tennessee. Formerly the man who's fronting Kansas. Here he comes, my buddy, John Elefante, everybody.
Thank you, guys. I love what you had to say, Kevin. I was very touched by that. And I do want to say there's nothing that can bring us together like music. I didn't have the pleasure of knowing Sib, but I grew up with Sib, musically. And I wanted to become a singer because of that band. And I've heard so many awesome stories about Sib. And I just wish I would have known it. I'm gonna break down here. I do want to say one thing. There's a good friend of mine that I do know very well, named Lou Graham. And he texted me, and he definitely has the flu. Really bad, so I'm going to keep him in prayer as well. We can do this in honor of him, eh? You can sing along.
Take advice, but someday you'll pay the price.
guy is one of the most honest guys I've ever met in my life. He's got a lot of heart, a lot of soul. And, you know, when it was time to pick songs, you know, we were all talking about upbeat songs, upbeat rock and roll songs. And, you know, John was struggling whether he should do this song. And I said, you know what, man, this is very fitting. This is very fitting. And I talked him back into it. He didn't want to do it, but I'm going to tell you, this is one of the most enriching songs for Kansas. And John sings it very well. And I just think it's very, very appropriate for the moment. So God bless you guys, and I hope you're having a good time tonight. Thank you, Kevin.
These guys work really hard. Very hard. And I appreciate it, guys.
You're welcome.
Now, I think this next song is very appropriate for Civvy. You agree, Kevin?
Don't forget Bernie. Hey, Bernie's filling in tonight for Jason. And he'd been woodshedding for 2 weeks, I guarantee you. 3 months. I'm sorry, I was wrong. Bernie's the man, and not only is he filling in on bass, but he's really, if you lose your cell phone, tell Bernie, because he found my cell phone in this building after I crawled around at 2:30 in the morning. He walked right up, reached into the chair, said, oh, is this it?
Now go to bed.
Go to bed, right.
This is our last night on the ship. These last nights are really not fun. All right, fellas, you ready? You sing with us, come on.
Carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no
yes.